We want to solve the system of three linear equations with three unknowns using the elimination method. It's important to keep in mind when solving a system like this that there are three possibilities. We can have one solution, no solution, or an infinite number of solutions. To show why this is the case, if we graph these in space, each of these would be a plane. If we graph three planes in space, if the three planes intersect in a single point as we see here, there's one solution. If there are no points that are on all three planes as we see here, because two of these planes are parallel, then there's no solution to the system. And then finally, it's possible that the three planes intersect and have an infinite number of points in common. As we see here, these three planes intersect in a line, and a line contains an infinite number of points. Therefore, the system has an infinite number of solutions. So going back to our example, let's first label our equations to keep things organized. We'll call this equation A, equation B, and equation C. For the first step, we want to select two equations and eliminate one of the variables. It doesn't matter which two equations or which variable, but let's go ahead and use the first two equations and eliminate the z terms. If we want to add these two equations together and eliminate the z terms, we want the z terms to be opposites. So if this is minus 3z or negative 3z, we want this to be plus 3z. So what we'll do is multiply equation B by negative 3 and add it to equation A for our first step. So we'll have negative 3 times equation B plus equation A. Well, negative 3 times equation B would be negative 3x plus 6y plus 3z equals negative 9. Equation A stays the same. Notice how when we add these two equations together, because the z terms are opposites, this would sum to 0. So we have negative 1x, or just negative x, plus 7y equals negative 8. Let's go ahead and call this equation D. And now for the next step, we want to select two other equations, but now we want to eliminate z again. So now let's focus on equation A and equation C. I always prefer to add the equations to eliminate the variables, so we want the z terms to be opposites. Notice how right now they're the same. So let's go ahead and multiply equation A by negative 1 and then add it to equation C. So we'll have negative 1 times equation A plus equation C. This will give us an equation that contains only x and y, and then we'll use that equation with equation D to solve for x and y. So negative 1 times equation A is just going to change the sign of each term. So negative 2x minus y plus 3z equals negative 1. Equation C stays the same. Again, notice how the z terms are opposites. This sum would be 0. So we have negative 1x, or negative x, plus 7y equals, this would be negative 8. So we'll go ahead and call this equation E. And now we're going to set up equation D and E as a system to solve for x and y. So we want to solve the system negative x plus 7y equals negative 8, and negative x plus 7y equals negative 8. And again, this was equation D and this was equation E. But notice how these two equations are the same, which means we are going to have an infinite number of solutions. But just in case we didn't recognize this, let's say we wanted to eliminate the y terms. Well, the y terms are actually both plus 7y. What we could do is multiply equation D by negative 1 and add it to equation E. Let's just do this and see what happens. We would have x minus 7y equals positive 8. Then equation E stays the same. And if we add these two equations together, notice how both the x terms and the y terms are opposites. So this sums to 0. So the left side is 0. And on the right side, 8 plus negative 8 is also 0. So whenever all the variables simplify out, we're left with an equation that's either true or false. If it's true, as we have in this case, we have an infinite number of solutions. If this happens to be false, we have no solution. When we have an infinite number of solutions, as we do here, we're often asked to express the solution parametrically, meaning we introduce a new variable to express the relationship between x, y, and z that would produce solutions to this system. For example, x, y, and z can't take on just any value and satisfy all three equations. They must be related in a specific way. For example, if we take a look at this equation here, we had x minus 7y equals 8. Well, if x minus 7y must equal 8, notice if we solve this equation for x, we would add 7y to both sides. We can say x must equal 7y plus 8. From here, we can introduce a new variable, let's call it t, where t can be any real number. So now notice if we let y equal t, we could say x is equal to 7t plus 8. Notice now we have a relationship between x and y, but we still need an equation for z in terms of t. So what we'll do is use these two equations to perform substitution into one of the original equations and solve for z. Let's go ahead and do this on the next slide. Take a look at equation b. If we wanted to solve this for z, we would add z to both sides of the equation and then subtract 3 on both sides. So using equation b, we could say that z must equal x minus 2y minus 3. Again, we added z to both sides, subtracted 3 on both sides, and then switched the order of the equation. And now to express z in terms of t, we'll substitute 7t plus 8 for x and t for y. So we have z equals 7t plus 8 minus 2t minus 3. Combine like terms. 7t minus 2t is 5t. 8 minus 3 is equal to 5. So we have z in terms of t as 5t plus 5. So for any value of t, these equations would produce a solution that would satisfy each of these three equations. It's important to recognize that these parametric equations are not unique. If we let x equal t or z equal t, these equations would look quite different but express the same relationship. And because the graph of each of these equations is a plane, and each of these solutions is a point on all three planes, the solution is often expressed using an ordered triple. The solution would have an x-coordinate of 7t plus 8, a y-coordinate of t, and a z-coordinate of 5t plus 5. Again, where t is any real number. Let's finish by looking at the graph of this. Here's the graph of the three planes. Notice how these three planes intersect in this black line. And since there's an infinite number of points on a line, this is why we have an infinite number of solutions. So for any value of t in our parametric equations, each value of x, y, and z would give us a point on this black line. Okay, I hope you found this explanation helpful.